Hi. So today I have a little practice for you here that's based on my forthcoming book and the training that some of you have already taken, Thai Yoga Massage for Wellness. This is a little routine that I came up with when I was trying to remember the flow. I find that if I practice the flow as my yoga practice or teach it in my classes, it really helps me remember. And it's been a little while since I've done that, so I'm going to keep this paper handy. Forgive me for looking at it periodically, but hopefully doing this practice will help you remember how that flow goes and keep it really fresh and comfortable, as well as keeping your body fresh and comfortable. So we're going to start out, like we do in everything in yoga, a little breathing. So sit up tall. Remember, this is important not just in yoga, but in your own yoga, your own Thai yoga massage practice too. So sometimes it can be really nice. Just take a few long, deep breaths with your client before you even begin. Just like you do at the start of your yoga practice. And we're going to want to keep this nice, steady breath going all through our yoga practice. We're going to start out with a little bit of neck roll and stretch, similar to what we do when we're working with our partner in our forearm shoulder rolls. So we're going to release the head forward. It's not exactly the same as what we do in our massage, but very similar. And then roll the head to the side. Oh, that should feel more comfortable and more familiar. And rolling the head back to center. Over to the other side. Look a few times back and forth. You can imagine that you're on your partner's pillow. You can turn your head as you roll it to one side, getting into some new areas. Do a little pec twist action. So lift your head up to center. Take your right hand behind your head. Relax that left arm. Drop your right shoulder. And then as you twist here, draw that left shoulder forward, that right elbow back. Remember the sensation of your partner holding you in this pose. See if you can find a little more relaxation than you might normally. Take a nice long deep breath. Turn yourself back to center, switch your arms left hand behind the head, dropping that left shoulder, leading forward with your right shoulder back with the left elbow as you find your twist. Coming all the way back to center. Do a little bit like our flying boat pose here. And we're going to take our feet together in Baddha Konasana. We take our fingertips behind us, so tent your fingers a little bit here. Let your knees move down. And then lift your chest forward and up, shoulders back, elbows back. Imagine your partner's feet on your back. Big breaths, open up. After your next breath, release your posture. Stretch your legs out nice and long in front of you. This is a variation of what we do with our partner in our Thai yoga massage. We're going to do a little forward fold with the legs straight. When you have people that are a little bit tight in the hips, sometimes straight legs feels a lot better. So just folding forward, let this be a nice yin stretch, meaning that there's no effort there. Imagine the weight of your partner's hands on your back. Just imagining that will often give you just a little more relaxation, a little bit more ease. And coming all the way back up. Know that you can also change that so that you do that as a cross-legged forward fold. And you both sides here too. This is more typical of what you'll encounter in your massage. We're gonna lie all the way down for a little internal external rotation. So turning the toes in, knees in. Turning the toes out, knees out. Remember, we're working from the hips here. And create a little bit of opening. You might notice things aren't quite the same from side to side. Pretty normal. And we move into our one-sided postures. We're going to start with hip rotation. So lift your left leg up and begin to circle in that hip. You get some clunks and pops. Know that that's normal as long as there's no pain. Reverse your direction. And we're going to come into our tree pose. So bringing the sole of your foot to the inside of your right thigh. As you do this, make it a little bit more dynamic by leveling out your pelvis. As your knee goes out to the side, usually that one side will drop down a little bit, so press the other side down. This takes a little core strength. Lengthen your thighs. And then swing that knee all the way up to your chest. Give it a nice big hug. Knee to chest. Stretching that leg so that the sole ends up on the floor. Bring the other foot to the floor too. Tuck your shoulders under. No part of your spine on the floor as you lift your hips up high. And then releasing down. And this time we're going to lift the hips only part way. Relax your bottom. And reach the knees forward. Your partner is doing a little quad squeeze here. Release your hips down. Stretch your right leg back up. Shift the hips over to the left and lift your left leg up. And we come into the hand twist, both feet flexed. Your arms nice and wide. Go as far as your body or your furniture may allow you. Remember that length that you get when you're receiving this. See if you can find that length on that top side. Lift the leg back up, shift the hips all the way back to neutral. And then we're going to do another bridge pose here. So 2 feet on the ground. This time we're going to do it a little bit differently. We're looking at mimicking the foot to thigh hip lift here. So lift your toes, so you're right up on the heels. Lift your hips. See if you can draw your toes closer to your knees here. And working as if we're doing that foot to thigh hip lift. And then releasing yourself all the way down. Stretch that right leg out again. Shift the hips to the left and we come into our second twist. Taking the bent knee across the body. Just like you're doing that transitional twist. Bring yourself back up, shift your hips to neutral and lengthen that first leg. And we'll move on to the second side. Beginning to create rotations in that second hip. Reversing your direction. And coming into your tree pose. Remembering to level out the pelvis and lengthen the thighs here. And here we're going to swing that knee all the way up towards the chest. Give it a nice big hug. Knee to chest. From our knee to chest, we're going to lower the sole to the floor, shift the hips over to that side, lift that leg all the way up, find our ham twist. If you want to do this with a strap around your foot, that's going to get you a little bit more hamstring action. And then bring that leg all the way back up. That feels like a long way today. Shift your hips back to neutral. Bring your soles to the floor, arms by your side. I'm gonna come into that gentle quad squeeze type of bridge. So lifting the hips, relaxing the bottom, reaching the knees towards the wall in front of you. Looking for a little length, a little space there in your low back and belly area. Then we'll lower the bottom all the way back down. And we come in to our next bridge. So we're gonna lift the toes up, just like we're doing a foot to thigh hip lift. Lift the hips, reach the toes towards the knees. And then relax it back down. Stretch that leg out, shift the hips to the other side, bent knee across the body. Finding your transitional twist, or Supta Matsyendrasana, as we like to call it in yoga. And then rolling all the way over onto that side, taking that top arm and beginning to rotate in the shoulder. Reversing your direction. And then tractioning the shoulder by reaching your fingers all the way down towards your toes. And a nice stretch in the side of the neck. And turning that into the pec stretch, taking your arm behind you, palm is up. Remember, you're looking for that nice opening right into the pecs. And then we transition that, turning the palm down, reaching straight out behind you. Just like your arm is positioned in the back walk, so bring your shoulders towards stacked here. And then we'll try all of that on the other side. So rolling all the way over to the other side, supporting yourself as you'd like, and beginning to rotate in that top shoulder. Finding that traction in the top shoulder, fingers reaching down towards your toes. And then sweeping that arm up behind you, palm up, looking for that stretch right in there through the pecs. Transitioning that to your back walk stretch, palm down, arm right out behind you, bringing your shoulders towards stacked. And then releasing that, rolling onto your belly here. Taking a little windshield wiper action. Feet from side to side. From our windshield wipes, we're going to move into our quad stretch. So reach back for your feet. Press your pelvis down. Press your heels towards your bottom. Bring your feet as close together as you can here. Remember to keep the knees comfortable. And if your bottom pops up, press it down. Lengthening out the legs. We're going to take a little bit of a stretch and a strengthener for our funky monkey pose. This is simulating what's happening when you're in the pose. So lengthen and lift one leg. Keep your lower belly engaged here. That'll help protect your back. Then lower that down one half locust on the other side. You're lengthening and lifting. And lowering that all the way back down. We'll come into our cobra, bring your arms by your sides. Press your pelvis down, chest forward and up, arms reaching back. Imagine your partner sitting there on your upper thighs, helping to anchor you to the floor. And releasing all the way back down. and we'll roll all the way up to our back. We'll take a little half happy baby, reaching down for your foot, holding the outer edge, tending your knee down towards the floor, bringing the inside edge of your foot to parallel with your torso. Taking a couple breaths here. And then stretching that leg out, and we'll do the same thing on the other side. Starting to get into our big hip openers here. And we'll release that leg, bringing the soles of both feet together. Lengthen your spine here and keep your sacrum on the floor as you draw your toes gently towards your nose. Resist this with your feet. So you're pressing your feet into your hands as you encourage toes towards nose. Lengthening the spine, couple big breaths. And releasing the feet all the way down to the floor, coming into some side stretch action with half moon pose. So feet go to one side, ankles cross, one arm up, that nice long side arm up. And we bend to the side, lengthening from feet to the top fingers. After a big long stretch on one side, we switch sides, taking the feet to the other side, other arm up, and look for that big side stretch on that second side. Bringing yourself all the way back to center. We usually do a tricep stretch one side at a time. We're going to do both sides at the same time here. So take your arms towards the sky, then palms up, fingers towards the wall behind you. Upper arms stay relatively parallel as you bend the elbows and bring your palms to the floor. Press the palms down, shoulder blades down the back. Look for a little lengthening there in the triceps and the lateral sides of the shoulder blades. Releasing your arms. We're going to simulate a little foot to armpit kind of action. So this means we're going to reach the arms down, stretching the fingers away from the shoulders. At the same time, ground your shoulder blades right to your mat. Releasing that effort, turn your palms up. Let your feet relax. Let your head relax. Visualize in your mind all the beautiful hand massage, shoulder, neck, and head massage. So you relax in Shavasana, letting it all sink in. Feel free to stay there in Shavasana for as long as it pleases you. Longer is always, always better. And notice how you feel in your body when you get up. May you be happy, may you be healthy, may you have peace.